Like most people, I had a crush. I always thought of real clever things to say. Like, I love you. He was 22, and I was on vacation.
This is a fine romance.
I turned 16. So I gave her my number, and she gave me hers. And that night...
Look, if we want to get married, we can get married. It doesn't matter what anyone says. Besides, Leroy and I are running away to be famous actors. We'll have lots of money, clothes, and we can do whatever we want. Nobody dares tell someone who's famous what to do. Now, ain't that better than sitting around with an apron on? Don't look at me like that. You always think it's so funny. Like it's a big joke or something. But I'm not kidding you.
Yeah, I'll get married and wear an apron like my mother. Only my husband will be handsome. Who are you gonna marry? Why don't you marry me? I'm not handsome, but I'm pretty. And I'd say, but I'm not a man. Says who? It's a rule. Good, we'll kiss like in the movies and then we'll be engaged. And my grandmother? She always wanted me to be like one of those sweet little white girls who was some people's dream of what was right in the world. Last week I almost laughed. It's It's only been a year ago that I crawled the walls. You know, I've been waiting for that day to come when I could walk the streets. People would look at me and say, "That's a dyke." And if they didn't like it, they'd fall into the center of the earth and deal with themselves. Maybe they'd return, but they'd respect me. You know, I suppose it's not so incredible, not so amazing. I found myself sitting here next to you, wanting to laugh. I must laugh at it. And it so happens to hit me here, at this moment, in the middle of a crowded restaurant. I dreamt about flying away from here. Only in my dreams, I could never fly fast enough. In my world, in my head, I was never alone. The world outside my bedroom window was brutal and needy. I wondered how I would survive, how I would escape. And where would I go? In my imagination, I traveled the world. I was as powerful as a bullet. I survived because I created my own heroes. Nobody needed to know I was somebody because it was my secret. I rode my big wheel down the street, pretending I was Eric Estrada, rushing on my motorcycle to save the life of some girl who desperately needed to be rescued. I want badly to yell out, but I don't want to cause a commotion. The tension makes me nervous. And we're all eating, like 800 million other faces. All of us concerned about what concerns us. And we're talking and listening, exchanging glances. Taking a drink. And me, I'm numb. I've got a headache. I can imagine a million places I'd rather be. I picture my life before. Before now. It was cool. And I start to feel more different now. Even in this room with 800 million other faces.
I'm getting busted.
One day, a man in a nice car tried to grab me off the street. He wanted to take me where he wanted to go. He wanted to do what he wanted to do. And it didn't matter if it made me sick. He was gonna do it anyways. Grandma said, bad things, they happen to bad people, so don't hang around them. I was in my dad's Chevy truck when I watched a station wagon full of people flip over and blow up. 1979. A woman walking along Nisky Lake Road in southwest Atlanta spotted a human leg on the ground. When the police arrived, they found the bodies of two teenage boys, Alfred Evans and Edward Hope Smith. 27 more children were found in the next 2 years. I never knew them, but I will never forget them. Because when these children were killed, every child died a little. My faith in the world was swiped from under my feet. And I thought of the day I was born, so proud of this life, and yet so uncertain of the world I had become a part of. I went down to the river, because nobody could find me there, not even the cops. Sometimes they'd catch me wandering around. They'd try to take me back to where you belong, they said, but they didn't know nothing about where I belonged. So I did it every day. Went on journeys for hours, miles. I knew that's where I belonged. 'Cause that's where I wanted to be.